Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and so I can do the exposition of the parables and Bible on my fingertips. There are corruptions in the Old Testament, which Jesus said, the old cloth dwelt holes. And it is useless. You can't patch it with the new, as there is done in the Bible. They put the old cloth, Old Testament, and with the new. And that's why the confusion, you know. In the old, you have Yahweh is the Lord. In New Testament, our Father is God. God is our Father, not Lord. Father has sons. Lord has slaves. So in the Lord, in the Old Testament, they have slaves under rabbis called disciples. But in Jesus, we don't have disciples. We have laborers working in the vineyard of our Father. And they were paid their wage at Pentecost. So with this brief introduction, so I go ahead and I haven't changed anything as it's written in the parable, in the Acts. So, but you should go by what I say. And it happened that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul passed through the inland country and came to Ephesus. There he found some laborers, not disciples. So we have to laborers. And not disciples. We are disciples of once born people. They can't understand gospel. And he said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed?" And they said, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." Holy Spirit with small s, you know, is called common sense. Holy Spirit with capital S is called extraordinary sense that can give you divination, as that slave woman was doing. So, and he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" Now, here is a corruption, you know. The baptism was in the name of Abraham, not in the name of Holy Spirit. The baptism of Jesus, Eucharist, is in Holy Spirit, and it is mocked by the church too much. They said, "Into John's baptism," and Paul said, "John's baptized with the baptism of repentance." It wasn't repentance, it was becoming faithful to Abraham. Telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is Jesus. This is corruption, you know. John the Baptist baptized in the name of Abraham, making them the sons of man, so that Jesus could turn them into the sons of the Most High. So only the Jewish men were baptized by John the Baptist. Jesus then took them over as laborers. He did not take any woman, because the woman was not baptized by John the Baptist, or a Gentile, no. Gentile could preach gospel, could be, but he doesn't need baptism. On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh dear, Lord has slaves. Jesus, our anointed elder brother, and not Lord. So this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. And when Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came on them, and they began speaking in tongues and prophesying. That is divination, you know, because Paul could give them divination if the people were clean-hearted and seeking his word. There were about 12 men in all, and he entered the synagogue and for 3 months spoke boldly, reasoning and persuading them about the royal kingdom of our Father God. Remember that he was well versed in, he was a Pharisee, he was well versed in the Old Testament, so he was trying to preach gospel in their own coins. But when some became stubborn and continued in unbelief, some stubborn like they should be circumcised, the Gentiles should be circumcised, and putting circumcision very important. But in Jesus, we don't need to be circumcised, because our heart needs circumcised. Speaking evil of the way before the congregation, he withdrew from them and took the laborers with him. Not disciple, you know. Disciple mean is the word from discipline. So discipline are children to be disciplined, you know, by a schoolmaster. So schoolmaster, rabbis and Pharisees, Lucy, they have disciples, not in Christ Jesus. We have laborers. Reasoning daily in the hall of Tyrannus. This continued for 2 years, so that all the residents of Asia heard the word of law of the Lord, both Jews and Greek. There is no Lord, you know, the word of our Father, and not Lord, you know. So there is a corruption, you know, in Old Testament you have Yahweh is the Lord, but is not in the New. That's why they were kept alienated from Yahweh, because he was very high Lord. And God was doing extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that even handkerchiefs or aprons that had touched his skin were carried away to the sick, and their diseases left them, and the evil spirits came out of them. So they realized the powers, holy powers of Paul, and in belief, you know, they were doing it. Then some of the itinerant Jewish exorcists undertook to invoke the name of the Lord Jesus. Jesus is not the Lord. Lord has slaves. He is our brother. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, and not the Lord Jesus, over those who had evil spirits, saying, I adjure you by the name of Jesus, whom Paul proclaims. 7 sons of a Jewish high priest named Sceva were doing this, but the evil spirits answered them, Jesus I know, and Paul I recognize, but who are you? And the man in whom was the evil spirit leaped on them, mastered all of them, and overpowered them, so that they fled out of that house naked and wounded. And this became known to all the residents of Ephesus, both Jews and Greeks. And fear fell upon them all, and the name of our Father, you know, is to be exalted, extolled. Our name of our brother, name of Jesus, and not the Lord Jesus, was extolled. Also, many of those who were now believers came confessing and divulging their practices, and a number of those who had practiced magic arts brought their books together and burned them in the sight of all. And they counted the value of them and found it came to 50,000 pieces of silver. So that the value of the book which they burned. So the word of our Father, not Lord, you know, the Lord continued to increase and prevail mightily, and hope that makes sense, and our Father God blesses you.